Gino Faella is the Director of School Facilities for the Newtown Board of Education.
Thank you. Do you solemnly and sincerely affirm that the evidence you shall give in the case on the question shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, upon pain and penalty of perjury?
Your name, sir?
Gino Faella. G-I-N-O. Faella, F-A-E-L-L-A.
I'm gonna allow for a little.
Could you repeat the question, please?
Has anybody ever asked you to sign an agreement or verbally told you not to discuss the conditions of the Sandy Hook School prior to December 12, 2012?
No.
Okay. So, if the school were to install a new security system, would you know about that?
Yes.
Can you look to your attorney? Just answer the question,
she
sir.
He doesn't look to me if he wants to.
No, not for an answer.
I'm not giving him the answer. Yes, I would know about it.
Was there a new security system installed prior to December 14, 2012?
No, there was not.
Mr. Faella, do you ever interact with any work orders that are produced in conjunction with maintenance or repair of the schools in the Newtown School District?
Yes, I do.
Okay. And were you involved in, or let me strike that. For these work orders, is there a process by which they are created?
Yes, there is.
And who would be the initiator of such a work order?
Several people.
And who are they?
That would be my administrative assistant, the maintenance staff, and the head custodians at the schools.
Okay.
Have the ability to generate a report.
Would the principal or the assistant principal be able to generate a work order?
Not in the computer system, no. It's a computer-based system.
Would those work orders, when they are completed, would they be signed by anyone?
No, they would not.
It's in order to try to determine exactly what they're looking for. Based on the request that was made, we could not determine what they were looking for, and there was never ever an interactive process. It was never clarified what they were looking for, and instead they just took the appeal. So I would object to the line of questioning concerning the emails between the principal and Mr. Faella. I'd also note that that request, and part of the problem was addressed, it said, assistant principal and Don Hochstrom and the maintenance department, as opposed to Mr. Faella and the maintenance. One of the many problems with that request.
Overrule the objection to the team. Yeah, or can you ask the question again?
Are you aware of any emails that may have come from school principal Don Hochsprung or her assistant school principal for the period of May 1st, 2012 through December 13th, 2012 to the facilities department?
Yes.
And have you reviewed those emails?
I don't quite understand the question.
Have you looked at them? Have you read them?
Of course.
Okay, so they exist?
I'm not sure.
Well, Attorney Frank can't help you with that. If you received them and you read them, then they must exist. Okay, that's okay. It's really difficult. All right, I'm going to show you what has been marked as Complainant's Exhibit B. It is a stack of work orders. Starting with the first page, work order ID 2698. And this is our copy, so sir, I will need you to hand it back to you when you're done looking at it. So, does that document look familiar to you at all in terms of shape and format?
Yes.
Okay. And do you have any reason to doubt that those are authentic copies of documents that were produced by produced in response to our FOIA request?
No, I do not.
Okay, so in other words, you think that those are copies?
These are printed directly out of our database.
Okay. Well, now, I noticed that at the bottom of exhibit, complainant's exhibit B, there's a place for two different signatures. One is the technician, and one is for someone to confirm that the work has actually been completed. Do you see that?
Yes.
Okay. So, it looks to me like, is it true then that the protocol, according to this form and its format, is for these work orders to have the technician sign off on them and the corroborating official to sign off on them when the work order is complete?
Yes. The way we do it is the technician completes the work order, initials it, hands it to my administrative assistant, and it gets logged in the database. We do not keep the original copies. We have no reason to keep all the paper. So it goes into a database.
So it's initialed only by the technician?
Mm-hmm.
There's no corroborating signature to make sure that the work order actually was in fact completed?
We have weekly meetings. We verify that the work orders verbally are being completed in a timely fashion.
Who at the school, if anyone, would verify that these work orders were actually completed?
They're verified. The work orders are billed or inputted from the custodians, typically the head custodian, or sometimes the maintenance folks themselves. So they would verify that the work was actually done.
So would that be Mr. Anzalotti?
That's correct.
Now, are you aware that of any school or Board of Education policy that requires yearly inspections of the school premises within your district every year by August 1st?
I'm actually not aware of that policy.
Well, are you aware that any inspections were conducted in 2012?
Inspections are done every year before the start of school.
So you're not aware of the policy, but you're aware that the inspections occur?
That's correct. A lot of them are state mandated.
Okay. And what is the purpose of those inspections that occur at the school on a yearly basis?
They're basic safety inspections, fire extinguishers, the PA systems, time clocks, fire pumps, fire systems, fire panel, etc.
Is there any inspection regarding cleanliness of the school?
That's conducted by myself.
And did you conduct such an inspection in 2012, by August 1st of 2012?
Yes.
And did you conduct such an inspection of the Sandy Hook Elementary School?
Yes.
And what were your findings?
Objection. What does this have to do with documents?
Well, because, well, we have never received those inspection reports, although they are the subject of this appeal. I direct Your Honor's attention.
Maybe you can help me out.
Okay. If I may direct Your Honor's attention to FIC 14-461, which has been marked as Complainant's Exhibit A. There is a FOIA request dated April 25th, 2014, directed to the first selectman. I believe it's also directed to the school board chair and to, well, those are the two relevant ones. In that letter dated April 25th, 2014, which constitutes the FOIA request made by former attorney Spinella, or the former counsel, attorney Spinella, for Mr. Halbig, subparagraph 5 requests Newtown Sandy Hook Elementary School hazardous substance reports, copies of triannual asbestos inspection reports, copies of any reports showing lead paint. It also requests...
And the town responded to those?
We did not receive those reports. We received a pre-demolition study.
Ask the witness.
I am trying to ask the witness. You raised an objection. I'm answering it. The objection was to the line of inquiry.
You were actually asking about a cleanliness report. No, that's not what is listed here.
Okay. Do you know whether or not there were inspections, triannual asbestos inspections reports generated for inspections of Sandy Hook Elementary School for the years 2002 through 2012?
Yes.
Where are those reports?
They were provided.
They were not provided. your position is that you have complied with that FOIA request?
We have complied, and you can verify that through the witness.
Okay. Mr. Faella, were you involved in gathering those documents for Attorney Frank to produce?
The asbestos documents?
Asbestos, PCB, lead paint.
The asbestos documents were gathered by me for Attorney Frank, yes.
And I'm looking at a document that says 3-year reinspection of ACBM. Do you know what that is?
Asbestos containing materials.
Okay. And it's dated July 19th, 2011, is that correct?
Which document? They're flush with it now.
Okay. I'm looking at the one dated July 19th, 2011. It's about 4 or 5 pages from the back. I think it's the 5th page from the last.
Yeah. Yes, I have.
Okay. You conducted a search for documents and you produced that document to Attorney Frank?
Yes, I did.
Was that the last inspection?
At the time, I believe it was.
Okay. What about the lead paint inspections? Can you show me where in this document those inspection reports were produced?
Okay, but just to be clear, the request is for the lead paint and PCB inside of the school for the year 2002 to 2012. And the town responded didn't have any.
All right, so let me direct the question to the witness. Mr. Faella, do you know whether or not there were any inspections for lead paint and PCB inside the Sandy Hook Elementary School for the years 2002 through 2012?
Lead paint and PCB inspections are not required. They're required under construction conditions and demolition conditions.
So your testimony is that they're not required and therefore you don't have them. Is that it?
That's correct.
Okay. Where are those work orders kept?
They're kept in a database.
So you don't keep hard copies?
No, I do not.
Okay. And were you the person who gathered these work orders that are contained in Exhibit CB?
My administrative assistant did.
Under your direction?
That's correct.
Okay. Do you recognize what that photograph depicts?
Yes, I do.
And what does it depict?
Objection, relevance.
What's the relevance for this?
The relevance is that we do not believe we were given all of the work orders relevant to a functioning operational school during the year 2011 through 2012 and 2012 through 2013. These pictures indicate, which the witness will hopefully testify honestly to, quite a bit of damage, mold, rot, damage contained within the building, outside of the building, water stains from flooding, sidewalk repairs that are needed, and I want to know where the work orders were for this, the repairs of these items. We do not believe that we received everything, and then we believe that given the conditions as depicted by this series of photographs, Commissioner, there should have been work orders generated for the repair of the school. And if so, where are they?
I would object to this line of questioning.
I'm going to sustain the objection. You self-admitted that you only have a percentage here. We don't. It could be that you still have the. I mean, I don't know what.
We reviewed everything, Your Honor.
It's not there. It's not there.
The question assumes that certain work orders are generated.
It doesn't assume anything. The question is merely to ask.
I think the objection is that we don't know anything. What these pictures are.
Well, the witness has indicated he recognizes what's depicted within the picture. He knows what it is, Your Honor.
It doesn't mean that it's relevant.
The pictures, Your Honor.
Well, what is this regarding the
other? Regarding the FOIA request for work orders. We do not believe we've received or had the opportunity to review all of the work orders. That is why we appealed.
Okay.
That's the substance of our appeal, Your Honor.
I'm going to overrule and then ask the question.
Okay. I think you have indicated through your testimony that you recognize what this picture is.
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
It's the front entrance of Sandy Hook School.
Okay. And have you ever seen what this depicts before? In other words, have you physically gone to the location and seen what this depicts?
I don't understand the question.
Well, you recognize it?
Yes.
Okay. So how do you recognize it? Yes, please, Attorney Brown.
Do you know, that that's the front of St. Luke's School?
Yes, I do.
Okay, do you know why those yellow tape is around those poles?
Yes, I do.
Why?
Was that this picture was taken after the incident?
Okay, I guess that's a better question. Do you have any idea when the time frame in which this depicts the condition of that, the school at that time that picture reflects?
I'm not sure when this picture was taken.
Okay, so what is it that you want to know about these pictures?
I'd like to direct his attention to the underside of the overhang, which indicates mold, damage, wood rot.
There's no wood rot. There's no mold. It's water stained from previous leaks. Water stained from previous leaks.
So was there a work order generated to correct this condition?
Between the period of July 1, 2012 and December 13, 2012, which is the relevant time period of your request.
All the work orders have been given for that time period.
Well, that doesn't answer my question, sir.
But it sounds you're asking a question about something that happened after the date of your request.
No,
Because this picture is from after the date of the request.
It is. You made inspections yearly, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Did you notice this before the date of December 14, 2012?
Yes, I have.
And did you create work orders to fix it?
No, I did not.
Well, why is that?
Judge.
That's not. Oops. We're done.
Sustained.
Okay. Well, let me ask you this, Mr. Faella. Were you aware of a flooding of the San Diego Elementary School at any time prior to December 14, 2012?
Judge, your relevance.
It's all going to a work order, so.
Here's the work order.
Says here. Do you know anything about it?
No, I do not.
So, to your best recollection, Sandy Hook Elementary School did not experience any flooding prior to December 14th of 2012. Is that correct?
In the period of time that I've worked there, that is correct.
Okay. Well, if I showed you pictures depicting mold and water stains taken just after December 14th, 2012, would it surprise you?
Objection. Does it matter whether it surprised me? Ask him if you recognize the document.
Do you recognize the document? Do you recognize what that depicts?
Yes, I do.
Okay. And do you notice any staining on the wall?
Yes, I do.
And what is that from, Mr. Faella, to your best experience and knowledge?
From my experience and knowledge, it's a form of algae, and we actually power washed it off the walls almost every other year.
What would be the procedure for documenting? Let me ask you this. Would your maintenance department have done the power washing themselves?
Yes.
So no work order would have been generated for the power washing?
That's an answer. Yes.
And why is that?
Objection.
So, okay.
I think it's a fair question to know, just for the record. What is the process and procedure for going about handling that kind of maintenance with the school? That's all.
In this particular instance, the power wash is located at St. Luke's School. Kevin Anzalotti would have done this himself, thereby as general maintenance and cleaning of the building. It wouldn't have generated a special work order.
Switching it on record.
Well, it says room 10. I can't verify the room number or what was written on here. It looks like a cork board in a classroom.
Okay. And if you had done an inspection and seen that cork board, would you have made a request for a work order?
Objection. I think they've got to establish the relevant time period.
When was this picture taken?
December 14th or 15th of 2012. It's from the crime scene photographer.
I don't object to this line of questioning. The work order is requested for period before December 14th.
Timeliness is after the request.
Okay. So you don't generate work orders for everything, just some things, is that correct?
We generate orders for most things.
For most things. How do you make the decision when to generate an order and when not to? Your attorney should not be able to help you, sir.
We try to capture as much work as possible, just to keep track of what's going on in the district as far as the work being generated and the amount of productivity. Do some things not get work orders? Yes.
And my question was, how do you make the decision of what does constitute a rise to the level of...
There is no decision tree to make. It's just some. We try to capture most things.
All right, Your Honor, I have no further questions for this witness.
So I'd like to continue this hearing to another date. I think that we can get together with counsel. We can get through the clerk's office and try and come to a mutually agreeable time for both parties. I don't know that we won't do that here. So I think that we'll just continue the hearing to a date upon mutual convenience of all the parties.
Well, Your Honor, I'm in a little bit of a disadvantage since my subpoenas were ignored by certain witnesses. I'm going to have to try to remedy that. The only other witness that I would be able to call today, which is purportedly here, would be Dr. Joseph Arati. Dr. Joseph Arati is the...
Arati.
Thank you. Is the Newtown School Superintendent of the Newtown Board of Education. I guess Your Honor does or does not want to continue the hearing today.
No, I do want to continue. I just know that it doesn't seem that we're going to finish it because we haven't
fair enough. Yes.
I can't believe filthy school, toxic waste, and you're proud of it. You ought to be ashamed of yourselves.
That was moved too. Good, ready?
What a bunch of liars. Unwanted person.
Dan Bedondi, Infowars.com. We're in Hartford, Connecticut with Wolfgang Halbig. How are you doing, sir?
Good. Thanks for coming all the way up here and taking a look at what's happening today.
Unbelievable.
It is. You know what? That is the classic word in Connecticut. It's unbelievable how they play with the law. They manipulate it. They play with it. Mm-hmm. And people laugh about it. These witnesses from Connecticut, they think it's funny. I don't think it's funny. That's a filthy, deplorable-looking school. It's a toxic waste dump. And they ought to be ashamed of themselves.
I seen them all with smiles, all wasting time purposely, so, you know, get you out of here quickly.
Oh, absolutely. They're dragging it. They got the heat turned up in here. Everything they can do to make it uncomfortable. But you know what? I've got a good attorney. I love Kay Wilson. She's not afraid to ask questions. And we'll be back. And they're going to have to answer, especially the one about Connecticut State Trooper. Can you imagine? You got a state helicopter that doesn't have audio tapes or record. What kind of state troopers are these?
I kind of found it hard to believe that the helicopter was not communicating with the officers on the ground. I mean, that was like, wow.
Well, you know what's really interesting? We actually have the flight log. Can you imagine the police chief says, oh, I don't know, I've never seen anything like that. That is the Connecticut State Police official flight log. And you know what it reads? To assist the Newtown Police Department in searching for suspects in the woods. Now, let me think how that works. How did a helicopter know they needed somebody? Somebody had to call them. And they lie like a dog. It's under oath. And they think they're going to get away with it? Absolutely. It's not if I can help it.
Not if we can help it.
I'm going to tell you what. America needs to wake up. This hearing is a game changer for America. And they ought to see it for what it is. They're playing silly games. They got attorneys who are hiding behind the truth, manipulating data. And this is the one. Did y'all hear today? The town. Well, you know what? They painted it with a broad brush. The town covers everybody. It covers the school board, covers the police department, and all they have to do is say, the town doesn't have it. And you're supposed to be happy about it. I want the answers from the school board. I want the answers from the police department. I don't give a damn about the town. But see, that's what they're doing. They're manipulating the law.
dash cam, it didn't have a clock.
Oh, the dash cam videos? I actually got the video. I got the video of Seabrook's dash cam. It actually has timestamp. They've refused to give it to me. They have it, and yet they refused, they altered, I think they tampered and altered the documents. That's a crime. Law enforcement can't do that.
And it's unbelievable. And now again, they're wasting time, so they now they want to prolong this, is that correct?
Absolutely. Again, they're going to drag it out. They're going to find ways to manipulate it, you know, and I guess we just have to do a better job, you know. Kay does a great job. I tell you what, I bless God that I found her, you know, because she is not afraid to ask questions. And it's not for Wolfgang. I'm doing this for America. I'm doing this for every parent, every grandparent. You know, we should have rights to ask questions, but not just that. We ought to be able to get the truth. We ought to be able to walk into an office and say, I'd like to see these documents. What are they hiding? This is serious stuff. Serious. Because who else wants a Sandy Hook and Air community? Nobody. It's got to stop. It's got to stop here, and it's got to stop now.
Absolutely. And I want to thank you for your time, Wolf, and thank you from a patriot to a patriot for your great and hard work.
Thank you.
And folks, again, you ask the real questions, you get ignored completely. It's unreal, it really is. Truth is definitely stranger than fiction. This is Dan Bedardi for Infowars.com.
Yeah. God bless you, brother.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Great fan of both of you guys.
Thank you.
Hey, I got children. This is what made me interested. These are my little guys.
Yes.
Okay?
You have a right to know.
Absolutely.
You got it. Let me tell you what. This is a grassroots thing. This
Thank you, sir. You're the only guy with the balls to do it.
Yeah. Thank you. My kids were traumatized just hearing about it.
Thank you.
I was traumatized by hearing about it.
Did you take a picture of us?
Yeah, I am. This is good.
Country is traumatized.
Come on in. Come on in. Hey, this will be history. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Hey. And I tell you what, the next challenge is going to be Jonathan Reich. We're going to clear him, and we're going to prove that damn medical examiner lied like a dog.
And the worst unbelievable, very disappointed.
I'm just very disappointed in the process. I know we have to play by the law. They got rules and regulations. But I just can't believe they don't tell the truth. They know what is truth. And what I didn't like is Monty Frank is the one that played the death card of the children. It wasn't us. Why did he have to bring up the 26 dead children? Because he wanted to bring what? Emotions back into the arena. All we want is simple questions. Where are the work orders? Where's the security system? The police chief doesn't know what an unwanted person is. You get a 911 call when somebody says shots fired and they put unwanted person. Nah, come on guys, we know better. Very disappointed in the process, but we'll be back. And I've got a good attorney, so.
When do you think that it'll be, if you had to guess? They
I don't
you
know, I really don't know. So my attorney's gonna handle it from here. You know, but we will come back, this is not over. And actually, even if the other hearing is over, this is just the beginning, because now we know what really the questions ought to be and what proper format we ought to use. See, we've learned here what not to ask and how to ask it and how to timestamp it. So actually, this is a learning lesson. Okay?
You're a hero, Wolf.
Oh, no, I'm not. I'm just old guy.
You are.
Thank you.
You are the greatest man in the world.
That means they have to release all the data. It's how we do it.
Yes.
You know, and
got to figure out how to do it quicker.
Yes.
How about the subpoenaed witnesses that didn't show up?
No.
Yeah.
How do you do that?
We can't even call our own witnesses.
Take care, Wolfgang.
Thank you.